The need to protect operations and customers' data and resources is critical for any organization. On the other end, the balance between security and convenience is a pivotal aspect of modern life. This is where the step-up authentication plays a vital role. My name is Yoel Horowitz, and I am a product manager with the Microsoft Identity Product Group. And in this video, I will be guiding you through the process of step-up authentication. Step-up authentication is a dynamic security authentication flow that adapts the risk level associated with a user's action, keeping users more productive and your resources more secure. As an illustration, an application allows access through Microsoft Entra ID or Microsoft Entra External ID requiring only basic authentication method, like username and password or sign in with a social account, without requiring a multi-factor authentication. However, upon a risky action, like high-value transaction or accessing sensitive data, the application requires the user to step up and prompt for a second and strong factor authentication. Let me first show you an example of step-up authentication. For the demo, I will use the Voodoo Groceries live demo. It's a global retail food store that is integrated with Microsoft Entra External ID for their online food shopping application.
Navigate to woodgrovedemo.com and choose the Select a Use Case button. From the list of use cases, I select the step-up authentication, read the instructions, and select the Start Use Case button. Sign up or sign in with my credentials. Woodgrove Groceries use Microsoft Entra External ID, so I can create a new account by choosing the Don't Have an Account link or sign in with one of the social accounts, such as Google or Facebook. While I enter my credentials, I'd like to remind you the step-up authentication applies to both Microsoft Entra ID and Microsoft Entra External ID for customers. Okay, I signed in. The step-up authentication use case pops up again with additional instructions. So, I add some items to the shopping cart until the sum of the items in the cart exceeds $50. For the demo, $50 or above is considered a risky action and I need to step up with MFA. Select the checkout button. If I have not yet already signed in with MFA, I will be asked to do so. So Woodgrove takes me back to the sign-in page to fulfill the MFA requirement. This demo used email MFA, so I enter the verification code sent to my mailbox. Good. Now the checkout process successfully completed. If I try it again, I will be able to complete the checkout process without the need to step up, since the MFA requirement already fulfilled. Before we moved on, I'd like to show you something more. If you select the use case again, you can learn how we configure a Woodgrove tenant. You can navigate through the steps, or you can also learn how we configure the tenant using Microsoft Graph. Now let me explain to you how it works. Microsoft Entra Conditional Access Authentication context gives you the power to demand enhanced strong authentication selectively from the users from within your application. As we saw earlier, users signed in to the application with their credentials. At this point, no MFA or additional security steps are required. After the user signs in, they gain access to the application. Only when necessary, and your application is the one to decide when it's necessary, and the user has not yet already satisfied the requirements, the application demands users fulfill additional access policy requirement. So, the application starts a new authorization request and passes an authentication context querying parameter. The name of the parameter is claims. This parameter contains a simple JSON string with an attribute called ACRS, with the authentication context your application requires, like C1. Microsoft Entra Conditional Access Policy evaluates the authorization request. If an authentication context was requested, conditional access would allow issue of a token only if all challenges were completed. Finally, Microsoft Entra returns a security token with ACRS claim, This claim indicates that the user fulfilled the requirement. For example, if the application asks for C1, the value of the ACRS claim will be C1. The ACRS claim is very important for your application, as it indicates that the user satisfied the application requirements. So, before allowing users to access a protected resource, the application should always check for the ACRS claim value. If the ACRS claim does not exist or the value is not as the one that application asked for, the application should not allow user to access the protected resource or complete the operation. Finally, let me show you how to configure your Microsoft Entra tenant. Sign in to Microsoft Entra Admin Center and navigate to Protection, then select Conditional Access. From the menu, select Authentication Context. Select New Authentication Context. Enter a name, for example, Access to Sensitive Data. You can also add a description. Select an ID from the list. Values C1 to C25 are available to use as authentication context IDs in your tenant. This ID will be used in your application. Create a new conditional access and give your policy a name, and select the users to be included or excluded in the conditional access. Go to the target resources, and under what this policy applies to, choose authentication context. Select the checkbox of the authentication context you created. In this example, I select the access to sensitive data. Under access control, select grant. Select grant access, then select require multi-factor authentication or authentication strengths. Set enable policy to on. Select create to create your policy. There is one more step. For your application to receive information about whether users completed the authentication context requirement, conditional access may issue the ACRS claim in the access token. From the menu, select app registrations and select your application. In this example, I select the Contoso portal. Under Manage, select Manifest. Configure the optional claims to include the ACRS claim. Add the ACRS claim to both the ID token and access token. When finished, select Save.
One of the primary benefits of step-up authentication is the ability to balance the security policies and regulations required by your organization with a better user experience. For most users' actions, users can enjoy a convenient sign-in experience with some minimal authentication steps. However, upon a risky action, such as when a user attempts to access sensitive data, your application will prompt for additional credentials like MFA. I recommend you to read our documentation. You can find the link in the description below. There are more features like triggering the step-up authentication from our web API and specify the client capabilities. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed and see you soon. Goodbye.